for hawker food at Bedok Reservoir Food Center. Welcome to another food adventure with Getting Lost. Today, we are at Bedok Reservoir Food Center to try this dish called kuih chap and a plate of noodles and a bowl of noodles. So join me as I eat my way through another food center, this time Bedok Reservoir Food Center, and eat all the good food there, which you will see after the intro. So join me there. Welcome back! So let's start with how to get there. First of all, get yourself to Bedok North MRT station, which is on the downtown line, and we are heading towards exit A. So what you do is, once you reach the station, get out of the gantry and then turn left. When you turn left, you see this corridor, keep walking down the corridor. On my right will be exit B, on my left, exit A. So you turn left again and walk straight down towards the escalator. And once you reach the escalator here, you need to get up, get on the escalator to go up all the way to the top. So take the escalator all the way to the top. Yes, the escalator moves. So all you need to do is just stand there and then magically, you will reach the top. Well, eventually, you will reach the top. Sooner or later, the top is coming. And once you reach the top, you walk straight, and then you turn right. And the road you see in front of you now is actually Bedok North Road. So, walk down the stairs. Once you walk down the stairs, you turn left and then walk straight down until you reach the bus stop. Or alternatively, at the MRT station, instead of taking the escalator up, before the escalator, you can turn right. And at this small little corner here, there's actually a lift or an elevator that will take you up. So press the button. Okay, once you get inside, and then press the button to take you to the top, which is the street level. So now you're at basement 2. This elevator, this lift, will reach street level or level 1. And what you do is, when the door opens in the bright, bright sunlight, you get out. Well, get out when the door opens. Then you walk straight. Then you turn left, continue walking straight again, then you turn left again, and then walk straight. On my right now is actually the taxi stand, on my left is actually the place where you actually put your, if you come here in the bicycle, you can actually put the bicycle there, and then here is Bedok North Road. So just keep heading down the road, following the traffic. Here again is the, I guess you call this the bicycle loading station place, I don't know what you call those place. Anyway, just keep heading straight down, walking past the taxi stand, and then following the traffic along Bedok North Road, walking straight, and on my left here, this is actually exit A. If you actually take the escalator up to the top, actually exit from here, you come down the stairs from here, and then you walk straight along Bedok North Road until you reach the bus stop, which is just a short distance a very very short distance from exit A. And what you do here, from this bus stop, which is the Bedok North Station exit A bus stop, take bus 60 from this bus stop, and then you alight two bus stops away. So when the bus 60 arrives here, get on the bus, and two bus stops away, you alight. Here we are now at block 629 bus stop. This is the two bus stops away from the previous bus stop. If you take bus 60, it'll bring you here. So once you get down from the bus, you turn right and head down this pathway until you reach the traffic light. And at the traffic light, keep walking straight, walk past the traffic light. The road you're on now is actually Bedok Reservoir Road. And you keep walking straight, and in front of you, you will see a overhead bridge. And just before the overhead bridge is where we're heading for, which is the Bedok Reservoir Food Center. So overhead bridge, to the left of it, here we are, the Bedok Reservoir Food Center, or the Pasar Makan at Reservoir. So this is the food center where we are going to have our food. And there's actually two portions. One portion is the market, another portion is the food center. And we're heading to the food center portion. So join me inside here and let's get eating. First up is this stall called Wan Liang Cooked Food. And this stall here is a very popular stall. Even before lunchtime, there's really a long queue for the food. And if you come here late, they will sell out. So come early. And on the signboard itself, it shows you all the different parts of the pig that you can have. And here, they cook all these different ingredients, different parts of the pig, in a very nice, delicious braising stock. And here, this stall here, like I said earlier, popular stall. So a lot of people will be lined up here. I actually lined up here to try to eat the food. And so here's the stall. As you can see, the owner here is busy cutting up all the different ingredients, all the different parts of the pig. The tofu, the fried tofu, the tau pork, even the pork belly, all cut up individually as you order it. And what I ordered from here is their kuay chap, which cost me $5.50. I ordered their mix set for one person together with fish cake. And here it is. First of all, I must say their kuay chap, they do it very nicely. I really enjoyed the kuay chap. It was smooth. It doesn't break easily when you pick it up with the chopstick. And it has a very nice texture that goes down to your throat very nicely. And the soup here has a very nice balance of flavor of the braising stock and the soup. And also, if they finish it off with some fried garlic, and which actually helps to make it very flavorful. And then that's the chili sauce. You eat together with your ingredients, which is like small intestine, the big intestine, the stomach, the tau pork, which is fried tofu, the pork belly, the fish cake, the egg. So here, what you have here, we have different items here. What I can say is, what was done well here was the small intestine, which was actually nice, soft and tender. The other items were just okay. But what I must say is they actually seasoned it very well with their braising stock full of spices, and then have a very nice, strong, porky flavor, and also a very strong soy flavor too. But one thing is, this is a bit salty. But what you need to do is, you can just eat it together with the chili sauce, which is pungent and sour, and it helps to cut through some of the saltiness. Overall, a very good ketchup. I really enjoyed it. Next up is another store that sells fried noodles called Cheng Fa Fried Kuay Tiao. And here they sell fried kway teow and also fried bee hoon, which they actually fry at the store. And I must say, they actually fry noodles very well here. So this is the $3 portion of the fried kway teow. As you can see, it's the dry style. And the flavor is more savory and spicy than sweet. And here, there's a very nice amount of spiciness to the dish. And the spiciness, how do I say this, does come a bit strong, and it does draw a lot of attention from the other ingredients in the fried noodles, but it still has a very nice egginess to it. And I also like the interplay of the nice firm egg noodles in contrast to the tender, soft, smooth kway teow, which is the flat rice noodle. And here, like I said, they fry the noodles very well, even though it is a bit spicy, but still a very good plate of fried noodles. If you do come here, you like fried noodles, this will be a good plate for you to try. Very yummy. And lastly, we are at this store called Yuan Li Shu Qi. And here, they sell fishball noodles. And what I ordered from this store is their $3 dry fishball noodles. This is it. One thing I must say about this store is, this is one of those stores that are, how do I say, has been around at this food center for a while. And the people who eats here are very familiar with the food, and even the owners know the regular customers and what's their regular order. So people will come here, they really know what they want to eat. But one thing I must say here is, I really like their dry noodles here. The noodles here is cooked together with a sambal that is savory, but still somehow the sambal here has a very delightful spicy sambal chili that is very nice together with the noodles. It reminds me a little bit of the noodles you get from Ruji Kitchen from Holland Drive Food Center, but just that it's a different type of sambal. But still, the sambal here somehow is delightful and goes very well with the noodles and makes it a very unique noodle dish and makes you want to come back for it more often and again and again and again. And so, this is Bedok Reservoir Food Center, a food center in the middle of Bedok Reservoir. And here, surprisingly, we found some good food. And if you're in the area, yeah, you should come down here and try the food. It's very interesting and something that you should come here and try, which I surely enjoyed it, and I'm sure you will too. Anyway, thank you very much for joining me for this food adventure that we had here at Bedok Reservoir Food Center. And if you like more, please do me a favor. Please help me by liking my video, sharing my video, and also subscribing to my channel. And if you like more videos, join me for my food adventures as I go all around Singapore to eat all the delicious good food. And I will see you at my next food adventure. I guess that's about it. See you there. Bye-bye.